pretty cool steering post. It allows you maximum control at all times. And some of the other manufacturers don't have that. It means a lot for a mountain.
So. Now, is Arctic Cat unique that way? Or?
Arctic Cat's not unique. The M Series sled that we've had for the last 6 years has always had a very good steering post, and that's kind of what set us apart from the rest of the industry. Polaris, with their new Arctic Cat Pro, is a very good steering post, and that's the only reason why that sled works, because the other manufacturers, Ski Doo and Yamaha, do not use a very good steering post, and for that reason, they're not conducive. The ergonomics are not correct for backcountry riding.
So what are the riders going to experience? You know, we've got a lot of fans out there that really love the M Series. As they transition to this new chassis, the way it operates, the function, the way the side hill, is it going to be transparent? Is it just going to be an extension, or is there going to be new riding skills going to be needed for this chassis?
No new riding skills, but maybe some adjustment. And it might take a half a day to feel comfortable on the sled, to learn the new the balance points of the sled. This is a very rider-forward sled, much more forward than ME. I'm not sure the spec runs in my mind is 8 inches further forward, which is substantial. But the sled doesn't pull you forward. There's still room to get back away from the handlebars. Where ME, I always found myself crowding the handlebars. Right, I needed to get forward. On this sled, I don't have to do that because it's balanced better.
What you're thinking about the new suspension that's migrated from the race sleds and brought into the suspension?
The new suspension works very well. It's calibrated. Arctic Cat has spent a lot of time finishing the calibration on this, so it works well in the bumps. It works well in the backcountry. If I could talk a little bit more about the sled balance, which is key. The biggest difference in this sled from the M Series is the balance. The center of gravity is higher in this sled, and what that does is it gives you the benefit of being able to pull the sled up on one ski easier. Okay,
but it doesn't make the sled tippy. You're right. Does it?
It makes the sled maybe a little tippy, but. For a good backcountry sled, you need it to be able to roll up easy and quickly. On the trail, the suspension's calibrated, so it's pretty firm, and it doesn't necessarily roll in the turns. But we're talking about off-trail riding for the worst part. In off-trail riding, we want the sled to be able to lock up on one ski and balance, with control, go through the trees, up and down, wherever you want to choose to go. Now, the sled is more agile than our Yummy, and it responds quicker to rider input than our old M Series. Okay.
One thing I used in the old race days is that the sled now has become more of an extension of you.
Characteristics of this sled are very similar to the right characteristics of the new Polaris Ski Doo actually offers a very good power package, but they've had to narrow their ski stance up to 36 inches to make it so that you can roll it up in sight mode. And we can achieve the same thing easier with a 40-inch wide ski stance. I believe Polaris runs the same 40 wide ski stance. Those are the biggest differences.
Achievement.